Now we will try to find the magnetic field intensity in case of infinitely long coaxial transmission line. Now consider an infinitely long transmission line consisting of two concentric cylindrical having their axis along the z axis. This is the surface at the top. The axis is this along the z axis, and the cross section of the line is this. In this case, we can consider the inner conductor radius A and the outer conductor inner radius B, and thickness of the outer conductor as T. So the outer radius of the outer second conductor will be B plus T. And if the inner conductor is carrying the current I, and if this current is considered as going inside, then this current, the current that is in the outer conductor, should be coming. If it is coming outward upside, then it should be downward, that is negative, or if it is downward, then it should be positive. So it must be opposite sign to carry the return current from the another conductor. So in this way, this is the structure assumption, and we have to find the magnetic field intensity in different regions of the coaxial conductor. So the first conductor is having radius A. So to find the magnetic field intensity, we have to choose the Amperean path to close the current in the regions where we have to find the magnetic field intensity. So the first case is, there are four critical points. First is this conductor, second is this region, third is this conductor, and fourth is out of the cable. So the four cases can be considered. First, if our point of interest is less than A, okay, so in this case, if Amperean path is considered like this, this rho can vary from 0 to A, that is this condition. Now second is, if Amperean path lies in this region, in that case we will try to find the intensity. So this is first Amperean path, this is second Amperean path when it lies between A to B, okay, and third is when our observer lies in second conductor. Considering that the current density remains uniform throughout the conductor, we are taking this assumption. So third case is that the point of interest lies in this region, that is rho can vary from B to B plus T. Next we can consider when point of interest lies away from the outer conductor. So in all four cases we will try to find the magnetic field intensity. Now consider the case one, when observer lies in the first conductor. In that case, uniformly distributed current is there, and this is the cross section. And in this case, according to the Ampere's law, we can write will be equal to the I enclosed, If current density is considered as J over the surface, then we can write like this, J S over, and consider any surface like this. Consider that is, consider the surface like this. This is ds. And in this case, the area vector will be in the direction of dz outward, and the h will be in this direction, that is in the direction of phi. If this is the current direction, then the curling direction of the finger will give us the direction of the h. Now j can be written as total current I divided by pi a square if the distribution is uniform. This is the current density, surface current density. It will be in the direction of coming outward, that is az. We can write this. And ds can be written as this length into this length. This length will be d rho and rho d phi. So it will be rho d phi and d rho. The direction of this ds will be normal to the surface coming outwards. So it should be in the direction of az as well. Now if we will find I enclosed, then it can be written as j is az dot ds, where phi varies from 0 to 2 pi and rho varies from 0 to a. However, the point of interest, the observer is varying from here to here. So at the current position of the observer, we can say I by pi a square. It can be rho square by 2. We are not putting the limit because we are interested to find at different position. And phi can be 0 2 pi. Integration of phi for full circle will give us 2 pi. Now from here we can say we can get 2 pi, and 2 pi will be cancelled out. I rho square by a square. This will be I enclosed at any particular point, at any particular radius rho. Okay. Now if we wish to find the magnetic field intensity H, now put this current in this equation, then H dot dl will be equal to the I enclosed, that is I rho square by a square. And if we find H, then it will be in the direction of phi, curling direction of the finger. Current is upward, so curling direction of finger, that is this one, it should be H phi in the direction of a phi. And dl will be in the same direction, so dl will be rho, this is dl, rho d phi. It will, the dot product in the direction of a phi, the dot of these two will give us 1. It should be h phi rho d phi for full closed path. It will be 2 pi. So combining all, it will be h phi 2 pi rho. If you will solve this for full loop, it will be equal to the I rho square by a square. And if we will solve this, then we can get h phi from here, that will be I rho square by a square by 2 pi rho. Rho will be cancelled out. This will be I rho divided by 2 pi a square. this will be H, and this will be in the direction of phi. That is the proportional to the rho when rho is between 0 to A. It is in this way, in the region inside the conductor 1, the magnetic field intensity will be I rho divided by 2 pi I square, where I is the total current that is coming out from the conductor, inner conductor. Now consider the case 2, where rho is lying in this region between A to B. In this region, if our observer is lying, then this is the Amperian path we can have, and the Amperian path can vary from A to B, from here to here. And in that case, from here to here, if we are having any path, in that case the current enclosed by this circle will be the total inner conductor, inner current. So the current enclosed in this case will be the total current coming outward, positive I. And if current enclosed we know, then H dot dl we can find H phi 2 pi rho. Now rho is not this, rho is this rho from here to here. 2 pi rho is equal to I, because this is the total current that can enclosed by this Amperian path which is lying between this to this. And the H phi will be I by 2 pi rho. So in the case when the current I is enclosed, in that case Amperian path will be this and the magnetic field intensity will be this. Phi indicates it is in the direction of phi. Same way here we can write in the direction of A phi. In both the cases it is same. Here we observe that H is directly proportional to the A, where remaining quantities are fixed. Here it is inversely proportional to the point of observation. Okay, consider the third case when our point of interest, that is observer, lying inside the second conductor. So in case third, when rho is lying between B to B plus T, in that case the current enclosed by this will be this current plus this current. This is the path considered as Amperian path. Current density for outer conductor can be written as, considered is J out for more specific way. J out can be written as the current from the outer conductor divided by the surface area of the outer conductor. So the total thickness is B plus T minus B. So we can say B plus T square minus B square. So in this way we can find the current density of outer conductor. Okay. And if we wish to find the current enclosed by the Amperian path, then we can say the current density J out times ds. Ds will be this area that is enclosed at the current position of the Amperian path. So J out from here I by pi b plus t whole square minus b square multiplied with, this will be, this is rho and this is b. So rho square minus b square. So this area will be pi rho square minus pi b square. So in this way we can write pi rho square minus pi b square. So this will be I enclosed by this Amperian path for conductor 2 only. Now if we will find the total current enclosed, then this current plus this current will give us the total current. Now total current enclosed by this Amperian path will be I enclosed will be inner current, that is plus I, and the outer current, that is minus I, because this is considered as coming out, this is coming going in. So this current plus this current. So I pi and pi from here can be cancelled out. So it will be rho square minus b square divided by b plus t square minus b square. This will be total current. And if we will simplify this, then we can find I. Okay, keep it as it is. Rho square minus b square divided by b plus t square minus b square. We can keep like this. Don't do anything else. This is I enclosed. And if we wish to find h, then in that case h 2 pi rho, as we have done earlier, in this case, in different cases we have done, it will be equal to the I enclosed, that is I 1 minus rho square minus b square divided by b plus t square minus b square. This thing. And from here h can be written as I by 2 pi rho 1 minus rho square minus b square divided by b plus t square minus b square. Okay, so this is for the case when observer lies inside the second conductor. Now consider the case fourth, that is observer lies outside of the coaxial line. In that case our observer is away from the outside of the cable. So in that case what we can say, the first thing that our interest is I enclosed. If observer lies somewhere here, for example this is the Amperian path for case 4, then the current enclosed by this will be plus I and minus I. So combining these two, the net current enclosed by this will be 0, and if current enclosed by this will be 0, then H will be 0, as H dot dl is equal to the current enclosed. Then from here we will get H is equal to 0. So what we obtain, that outside of the coaxial transmission line the magnetic field intensity is 0. This is one of the advantage of that. If outside of the field is 0, the radio interference will not be there. Now if we sketch the magnetic field intensity in terms of rho, then we can find this is rho and this is magnetic field intensity. It is in the direction of phi, so you can indicate phi or if you feel okay, otherwise no need. So there are four cases from 0 to A, and from A to B, from, okay, keep it quite away, from B to B plus T, that is this, and B plus T to onward. So B plus T, you can say, you can name it C, you can name it, otherwise it is up to you. And after B plus T, this is the other region. So let us start. In the case one, when we derive, then we find that H is directly proportional to the observer length from the center, that is rho. So remaining things was constant, it was directly proportional to the rho. So from here to the center, it was directly proportional. Okay, so at this point, or you can, for more clarity, you can have more slope up to A. Okay, up to this point, it is directly proportional. So at this point, it is I by 2 pi A. If we are at A, then this is I by 2 pi A. One row will be cancelled out. Row will be A. So at this point, field is this. And in between, it is directly proportional. Real linear relationship is there. And due to absence of constant, it will pass from center. In case 2, it is inversely proportional to the rho, that is from A to B. From A to B, it is inversely proportional, and at B, it is I by 2 pi B, we can say. So B is, for example, here, then we can say at this point, the H will be I by 2 pi B, and it is inversely proportional. And in case 3, that is, we find the intensity is inversely proportional to rho, and there is further reduction. So it will follow further inverse relationship. However, up to which point it can reach? When our rho can be up to B plus T. So if we will put 0, B plus T, so it will be 1. If it will be B plus T square, then this, and this will be cancelled out, it will be 1, and 1 minus 1 will be 0, H will be 0. So at B plus T, it will, H will be 0 at this point. And after that, 0. And after this, the region 4 will be there, and in fourth case, the I is 0, so H will be 0. After that, the relationship, the characteristics will follow this. So this is the full characteristics of magnetic field intensity in coaxial transmission line. Now, if we summarize, then we can say H is equal to I rho divided by 2 pi A square, when rho is from 0 to A, and H was in the direction of A phi. In all the cases, we find that H is in the direction of phi. And when rho is more than A, less than B, equality you can put according to your suitability. And if we have this region, then I is nothing, just 2 pi rho in the direction of A phi. And the region when rho lies between B and B plus T, in that case, I by 2 pi rho, and consider it, the full section can be considered as C. It is C in the direction of A phi. And if If rho is greater than B plus T, in that case magnetic field is zero. So this we can say in summary of the magnetic field intensity in the case of coaxial transmission line. Now from all the study that we have done until now, concluding all from them, we can say Ampere's law can be used to find magnetic field intensity only due to symmetric current distribution, for which it is possible to find a closed path over which H is constant in magnitude. So this is the you can say limitation of Ampere's law to find the magnetic field intensity. So that is it for finding the magnetic field intensity with the help of Ampere's law.